We are moving on to the next news, which is a little bit depressing. This was a very positive one. The next news is a little bit depressing, not depressing, actually alarming. Okay, so I'll take you to the next news. One second. Now you can see it?
No. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, this is the United Nations page. Okay, United Nations news page. Whenever you want to know some news in detail or about need to read about something in depth, you can definitely visit this page. You see over here are the different topics: women, law and crime prevention, culture and education, health, climate and environment. There is peace and security. All these topics, on all these topics throughout the world, all the United Nations allying countries, they have their news over here. This is the United Nations page, and it shows a very alarming news, where it shows that Canada is breaking the heat wave, and it is like a pressure cooker now. Canada, which was extremely known for its cold weather, the glaciers and the Rocky Mountains, it has shown extreme high temperatures. You can see the news. An exceptional and dangerous heat wave is breaking in northwestern United States of America and western Canada. This is obviously a part of the world which is more accustomed to cold weather. Right, we all know Canada always like have cold weather, but this time what happens, see below, it is 47.9 degrees Celsius. 47.9 degrees Celsius is the recording temperature. Okay, and don't forget that this is the province which has the Rocky Mountains, the glacial natural park, and if it starts increasing more, then obviously these mountains will lose the ice in them, and it will be an extreme threat. There will be floods and landslides and everything. Okay, you can see in this video the portions which are experiencing the heat wave. See, an extreme heat wave going through Vancouver, Oregon, and Washington. These are the few places which are experiencing this extreme high temperature in Canada. Okay, so what can you tell me about this? Why do you think this temperature is rising? Can anybody tell me? Shriduti, can you tell me what is your view on this extreme temperature rise?
Ma'am, because of the global warming.
Absolutely, because of the global warming. Okay, Dipanjan, can you tell us, enlighten us a little bit about global warming? Dipanjan?
Ma'am, global warming is a natural phenomenon in which the overall temperature of the atmosphere increases rapidly, and due to this increment, many side effects happen to our environment and also biological diversity. Like, due to increasing temperature, the ice caps can melt down, and this can cause a shortage of habitat for that and for those animals in the poles, and also it can increase the water level. Increasing the sea level in the waters can cause many disturbances in the coastline areas of the world. So it is a very dangerous phenomenon and the most endangering threat of us in recent days.
Very well said, very well said. Agniv, can you tell me, Dipanjan has said it is due to the rise of temperature. What is the main reason behind this rise of temperature? Global warming is what we are calling this rise of temperature, but what is the main reason? Agniv, can you tell us? Yes, anybody wants to say?
Yes, ma'am, can I?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, because of the cutting of trees.
Cutting of trees is one reason, but there are some more reasons. Can anybody
due
explain?
To the factories. It is producing
factories. So what is happening due to the factories? I want a specific word. You all are missing that word. Due to the cutting of trees, due to the increase of
CO2 level.
And deforestation.
Due to the increase of CO2 level, it is reducing the ozone layer and the
Absolutely, the depletion of the ozone layer is one of the most important causes of the global warming. Depletion of the ozone layer. So can you tell me the ozone layer is getting depleted due to the greenhouse gases, right? So can you name one of the greenhouse gases? CO2 is one of them, definitely. And other?
Methane.
Then there is one specific gas which is used in two of our technical gadgets, which we use a lot nowadays.
CFCs.
CFC. CFCs are used in which two technical things that we have in our homes? ACs and refrigerators. And nowadays there are so many official complexes which are centrally AC, right? So think about the amount of CFC that is getting getting its exposure in the air, all the kind of due to the less number of trees, due to the increase of factories, due to the increase of the CFC gas in the air. All these are reason behind the ozone layer depletion. And when the ozone layer is getting depleted, the ultraviolet rays are reaching the earth surface more and more, causing the global warming in an increased fashion, right?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, here comes a funny fact that due to the increasing use of ACs, we increasingly need the use of ACs.
Absolutely. This is the funny fact. See, the one who is making it is the one who is trying to protect us from the heat. Or maybe one who is trying to protect us from the heat is the one which is making it.
Yes, right? Ma'am.
Absolutely. So these were the two important news I wanted to share with you people. And I got very interesting updates from you people, and your analysis were also very interesting. So I think for the next week, you can bring up your own news materials. Now you would be able to make out your own news materials for the next week, Thursday.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.